Hey, this is Max here, and in this video you will learn how you can use the wait action inside automations in ActiveCampaign. It's pretty cool what you can do with it. You can just set it to wait a certain amount of time, or you can use the wait until feature, and then you can wait until a series of conditions is met. And that's what I want to talk about today. So let's just dive right in, and then we'll show you some cool examples. So over here you see just a regular automation, and inside this automation we have an email. So someone gets the email, and then what we want to do is we want to send one email one day later, so 24 hours later. So to do that, it's pretty simple. We just click this plus, then we go to conditions and workflow, and we click wait. Then we get two options. So the first one is to wait for a specific period of time, and the second one is to wait until specific conditions are met. So if we just want to wait for one day or 24 hours, then we just click wait for a specific period of time, and then we set this to wait for one day. And as you see here, you can also set it to minutes, to hours, to weeks, to months, or to years. So I would leave it to one day. And then you could add another email, and then that email will be sent exactly 24 hours after the first one. But now imagine you want to send the second email the next morning at 10 a.m. Because if you do it like this and you would have an email here, then that email would be sent exactly 24 hours later. So if someone gets the first email at, for example, 10 p.m., like imagine it's maybe a lead magnet and in the evening they signed up for that lead magnet, then the next email will also be sent at 10 p.m. So then what we want to do is we want to add two waits. So first we want to say wait until, and this is really cool because then we get the conditions editor, and in the conditions editor we can set conditions, and then when those conditions are met, then the contact will continue to the next step. So then what we, for example, want to do is we want to say current time, and then you can choose the current time in the context time zone or in your own time zone. So I'm in the time zone Europe Berlin, so in this example I would just choose the context time zone is 12 a.m. So then it will wait until midnight, and then I want to add a second one that says wait until current time in the context time zone is 10 a.m. And then we click save, and then we could add another email. So now it sends the email, the contact will wait until midnight and then until 10 a.m. and then it can send the email. So why do we use two wait actions and not just one? That is because if you would only have the wait until 10 a.m., then imagine if someone gets this email at 7 a.m., it would already send the next email 3 hours later. So if you really wanted to send the next morning at 10 a.m., you have to wait until midnight and then wait until 10 a.m. Now, then another cool thing that you could do is you can also wait until specific days. So you could say here, wait until current day of the week in the context time zone, or again in your own time zone, is Wednesday, for example, or you can also say here weekend or weekday. This is also pretty cool in case you maybe only want to email people during the week. But in this case, you could say Wednesday, and then you can add a second condition. So wait until the current day of the week is Wednesday, and current time, context time zone, is 10 a.m. And then we click save, and we click save again. So then the email will be sent, then the contact will wait until it's Wednesday and it is 10 a.m. So in this case, you do not have to use two wait actions. Now, then another one that I want to show you that I think is really cool is that we can also wait until someone opened the first email. And then based on that, we can send another email if they opened it or not. So we could do here, wait until has opened, and then we select our email, awesome email, click save. So then people will be in this wait action until they open the email. Now, what is also cool here is that you can also set a time limit. So if people do not open this email, they will basically be stuck in this wait action forever. So what we can do is we can set up the time limit, and then we can say, okay, we want to wait for up to 2 days. So what that does is that people who open the email, they will continue right away because that's the condition that we have set. And people who do not open the email, they will continue after 2 days because that's the time limit we have set. Now, and then what you could do is you can add an if else. I also created a separate tutorial about that. So then we can say here, has opened, awesome email, click add. And then we have a path for people who opened the email and a path for people who did not open the email. So then what we can also do is we can also wait until a specific date. So this may be cool if you have a challenge or you're doing a workshop that's starting on a certain date or you're doing a promotion, something like that. Then you could also, for example, before you send this email, you could say, okay, wait until, and then we could say current year, for example, current year in my own time zone is 2020. Then and current month in my own time zone, September, and current day of the month in my own time zone is 10, for example. So then someone would only continue if it is the year 2020 and it is the 10th of September and we set no time limit, and only then this email will be sent. Now what you could also do is you can also say here, wait until the current day of the month is on or after. So then even if it's already, that contact is getting in this automation after the 10th of September, for example, the 16th of September, then they would still get this email. Now then I want to show you one more really cool one. So this one is a little bit more advanced, but imagine you send this email and then you only want to continue if they're not inside another automation. So then you can say here, wait until, and then we say not currently in automation, and then for example in my 5-day challenge. So then only people who are not in the 5-day challenge, they will continue to the next step. So those are my favorite use cases of the wait action, but there's actually much, much more possible with it. You can also wait until someone is in a certain automation, or wait until someone has a tag, or wait until a specific custom field has a certain value, or wait until someone became a customer, like all kinds of cool stuff possible to make your automations a bit smarter. So if you have any questions about this, just let me know in the comments below. I reply to every single comment.